Hello, this is a presentation about cancer and we are going to show you the meaning, the treatments, the types and causes about the cancer. It's important to know about the cancer because we don't know when or at what time we are going to face this problem, or maybe one part of the family, we don't know everything. And so it's important to know about it and know what things we should have to avoid, what situation, what kind of food, everything that sometimes we eat and we don't know what for what we are doing.
Cancer is a group of diseases involving abnormal cell growth with the potential to invade or spread to other parts of the body. Not all tumors are cancers, but begin tumors not spread to other parts of the body. Possible signs and symptoms include a new lump, movements among others, abnormal bleedings, a punch count, unexplained weight loss, and changing bowel movements. While these symptoms may indicate cancer, they may also occur due to their diseases. There are over 100 types of different cancers that affect the human. Signs and symptoms. When cancer begins, it invariably others to know symptoms. Signs and symptoms only appear as the mass continues to grow or ulcerate. The findings that result depend to the type and localization of the cancer. Few symptoms are specific, with many of them also frequently occurring in individuals who have other conditions. With cancer is a new rate incinerator, thus is not uncommon for people designed with cancer to have been treated of the diseases which were assumed to be causing their symptoms. The cancer have different classification, and cancers are classified by the type of cell that the tumor cells resemble and is therefore present to be origin of the tumor. And their types include carcinoma. Cancers divide from epithelial cells. This group includes many of the most common cancers present in the age and include nearly all those developing in the brain, prostate, pancreas, and colon, and sarcoma. Cancers are seen from connective tissue and bone, cartilage, fat, nerve, each of which develops from cells originating in measuring chemical cells outside the bone marrow. Lymphoma and leukemia. These two diseases of cancer arise from hematopoietic and blood-forming cells that leave the marrow and lend to mature in the lymph nodes and blood, respectively. Leukemia is the most common type of cancer in children, accounting for about 30%. And germ cell tumor. Cancers derive from pluripotent cells, most often preserving in the testes and the blastoma. cancer derived from immature precursor cells or embryonic tissue. Blastomas are most common in children than in other adults. Cancers are usually named using carcinoma, sarcoma, or blastoma as a suffix with the Latin or Greek word for the organ or tissue of origin of the root.
More than 60,000 billion cells make up the human body. They are the units that form the tissues which make up our organs, like the liver, heart, and lungs. When the body needs it, our cells split into two and replace those cells that are defective or have come to the end of their lifespan. This makes it possible for our tissues to preserve their shape and their respective functions with the passage of time. Every cell is therefore programmed to multiply and die. This ordered but complex program is controlled by the center of the cell, the nucleus, which contains chromosomes containing many genes made up of DNA. Sometimes, some of these genes undergo a change. The nucleus then sends out abnormal orders and the cell goes wrong. It multiplies uncontrollably and takes on a life of its own. Each new cell produced contains the same defect. The cells proliferate chaotically and form a tumor. This process may be short, but is often long. 10 to 30 years may separate the birth of a first abnormal cell from the appearance of a tumor of about 1 cubic centimeter. The tumor forms many blood vessels in order to survive. These will supply the tumor with oxygen and nutrients, allowing it to live and grow. This is what we call the phenomenon of angiogenesis. The tumor, however, only really becomes dangerous when the cancerous cells begin to invade through the vessels into the adjacent areas and spread to the surrounding organs. These cells can then invade other parts of the body, multiply and produce new tumors. Metastasis is the term used for this spreading process. But why does a cell become cancerous? There are many factors and they can exist to different degrees. Factors have been identified such as hereditary genetic anomalies, exposure to some viruses, HIV, hepatitis B, C and D, papillomavirus, Epstein-Barr virus, exposure to toxic agents, chemical products, radiation, sun, unhealthy behaviors, such as the consumption of alcohol and tobacco, or a diet too rich in fat and low in fruit and vegetables. Today, over 25 million people in the world live with cancer. 7 million die from it each year. The disease represents the leading cause of mortality for those under 65. Lung cancer is the most widespread, followed by breast cancer, colorectal, stomach, and prostate cancer. The means to combat cancer do, however, exist. These often complementary treatments are used alone or in combination according to the type of cancer and its status. The goal of the treatments is to make it possible to eliminate the tumor and cure the patient in early stage cancer, or like a chronic disease, to control its development. There are mainly three kinds of treatment. Surgery consists of removing the tumor in part or in its entirety. Radiotherapy exposes the tumor to radioactive rays, which prevent the diseased cells from multiplying and destroys them. Chemotherapy consists of administering systemic medicinal substances to destroy the cancerous cells or prevent them from spreading. Chemotherapy and radiotherapy act on cancerous cells, but also on healthy cells, which explains their side effects. But today, better knowledge of the characteristics of cancerous cells makes it possible to develop therapies that target the cancer development mechanisms more specifically. Sanofi Aventis R&D is already present in all these areas to fight against cancer on all fronts.
tonight I will talk about causes of cancer. Risk factors. Usually, it's not possible to know exactly why a person develops cancer and another does not. However, the studies have shown that certain factors called risk factors can increase the chances of a person suffering from cancer. Although some of these risk factors cannot be avoided, such as age, others as milk consumption itself can be avoided. Genetic. Cancer is due to change in the genes that control how cells multiply and divide. A small group of cancers are caused by inherent genetic change, but most of the changes that cause cancer occur during a person's life. There are genetic tests available to detect inherent mutation and to find alterations found in tumors. Some cancers are caused by things people do. Smoking increases the chances of developing lung cancer, mouth esophagus. Excessive alcohol consumption also increases the likelihood of lip cancer, stomach occurs. 75% 75 to 80% of cancers are due to the action of external agents acting on the body, causing alterations in the cells. By being external, they are modifiable. The person can change their habits, preventing the body from contact with these agents, such as avoiding snuff consumption, reducing the dose of alcohol, exercise helps reduce its incidence. In the other 20-25% of cases, they do not know the exact mechanism by which it's occurred and cancer develops. It is thought to be due to a spontaneous mutation of genes or by the action of some external factors that has not yet been identified. Today is one of the main research topics. External agents are called risk factors or cancerogens. Are substances with in contact with an organism or capable of generating in him cancerous disease. His nature is varied, having on physical, chemical, and biological factors. For cancer to be produced from 4 to 6 cellular mutation or genetic alterations, so everything suggests that risk factors must be in contact with the body for a considerable period of time, like years. This will also explain that the risk of suffering from cancer increase with age. In some cases, very few, 5 to 7%, people have a genetic predisposition to developing certain cancers. This occurs because altered genes are inherited. The result is that in these people, the chance of getting cancer increases and the time required for its appearance is less than when they're in no such predisposition. Most chemical cancerogens are released to industrial activities. So much of cancers produced by them are given in developed countries. Of the 7 million now chemical compounds, some 2,000 describes some kind of characteristic activity, cancerous activities, and very few are in direct or indirect contact with humans. Moreover, regardless of this composition, the ability of the substance to cause cancer will depend on the amount of doses received and the time of exposure to the substance. Arsenic, benzene, cadmium, mercury, nickel, lead, chlorinate, hydrocarbons, naphthalene are some of the most common carcinogenic agents with activity. Among physical agents include ionizing radiation, non-ionizing radiation, and the radiation emitted by the Earth crust itself. Another source of carcinogenic physical agents is caused by nuclear accidents such as leak produced in nuclear plants. In recent years, biological agents are increasing, taking center stage in human cancerogenics. Today, we know that 80% of cancers are attributed to persistent infections caused by viruses, bacteria, or parasites. Among with the human papillomavirus, cervical cancer, the hepatitis B, liver cancer, and Helicobacter pylori, stomach cancer.
I'm going to talk about the treatment for cancer. The first treatment for treat cancer can be the surgery. That is a procedure in which a doctor called surgeon with a special training remove the cancer from the body of the patient. Another treatment for treat cancer is radiotherapy. These use a high energy radiation from X-ray, gamma rays, neutrons and protons and other sources to kill cancer cells and shrink the tumors. The radiation may come from a machine outside the body or from radioactive material placed in the body near cancer cells. Another treatment that is used for treatment cancer is the chemotherapy, that is the most used, and this consists about the use of drugs to kill the cancer cells. Chemotherapy is distributed systematically and act both locally and in all areas of the body, and can kill malignant cells that are removed. Another treatment is the immunotherapy treatment that helps to the immune system to fight the cancer cells. The body this helps to the body natural defenses to fight this cancer. And these use materials produced by the body or made in a laboratory to improve, target, or restore immune cells functions. Another treatment is the targeted therapy. This treatment also consists that acts on changes that promote growth, division, and spread of cancer cells. Drugs are the substances that block the growth and spread of cancer by interfering with specific molecules involved in the growth, progression, and spread of cancer. They also exist the hormones therapy, and this treatment what does is slows or stop the growth of cancer using hormones to grow. And the last treatment that is used for a cancer treatment is the stem cell transplantation. This procedure restores blood-forming stem cells that were destroyed by the high doses used in cancer treatments, such as chemotherapy or radiotherapy. And so these were all the treatments that the medicine used for the patients for that have cancer.
It's very common for someone to have breast cancer now in my age. I have found that it's not a rarity anymore. People need to wake up and pay attention, you know, because it's people, they're losing their daughters, so you're losing the babies of the families. So I was diagnosed last November 22nd, 2 days before Thanksgiving, 2005. So that was a delightful Thanksgiving celebration for me and my family, of course. I was diagnosed with stage 4 metastatic breast cancer, and once you're diagnosed with stage 4, you don't go back. You're never downgraded to stage 3 or stage 2. First, the doctors told me that I had what is called mastitis. Mastitis is something that women who are breastfeeding can generally get. Last time I checked, I don't have any kids, so I was unsure of how I would have mastitis. So I questioned my doctor, but he just sent me home with antibiotics and a lot of Vicodin and said, just call me in a week if you don't feel any better. And that's what happened. I called him a week later, tumors kept growing. I kept feeling something growing inside me. Basically went back in and sent me to a surgeon. And the surgeon had said the same thing to me, barely gave me a breast examination. I said, well, I agree with your primary care doctor. You know, I still think that this is some weird, strange, unusual, rare breast infection that you have. Could be mastitis, could be something else. It's uncommon for you to have mastitis, yes, but I still don't think it's breast cancer. You don't have breast cancer, Stephanie. The reason that they were so adamant with me and convincing me that I did not have breast cancer is because of my age. The one thing that I kept hearing over and over and over again was, you know, Stephanie, you're 30 years old, you're in perfect health. You don't have breast cancer. This is not what this is. I don't believe that's what this is. It's just some kind of breast infection. It's my age. That was a huge factor. And the fact that I walked into their office looking like this, with the exception I had hair, but... What has changed in this world for me to have the diagnosis that I have, I believe, is the interior and exterior environment. It is the makeup of your environment, whether it's outside your body or your immune system inside your body. It's what's going on with that. There is a reason why I got what I have. There's a reason I got breast cancer at 30 years old, when the common age for breast cancer is 60. There's a reason it's not only happening to the mothers and the grandmothers of our society. It's happening to people like me, the daughters, the babies of families, the little sisters, the younger girlfriends. There's something that's going on. There's something that is in the air, there's something in the environment, there's something chemical-wise that we're putting in our body. It's a combination of your interior and exterior environment, and it needs to be researched further. We definitely need to find out what those the contributing factors are, the components of that make up this illness and why it's happening to the younger generations. I had the pleasure to travel to Washington, D.C. for the National Breast Cancer Coalition Conference. I think because I was the youngest one there attending this conference and training, and I was the only bald-headed female there, they really wanted to make sure that I was kind of pushed to the front of the lines, the fronts of the groups, the first person to walk into each and every congresswoman and man's office because of the impact that they knew and I knew I would make. It's a visual, and when you get a visual of this, how could you not be affected? We need to have more funding for research. The Environmental Research Act that the National Breast Cancer Coalition is trying to pass is one of those contributing factors that will help get us closer to finding a cure. I mean, it's something that needs to be passed. It's something that needs to be enforced. It's something that people need to get out there and support and become aware of it. The Stephanie LaRue Foundation is a nonprofit foundation that I've created to work with all of the other breast cancer organizations, but will specifically be geared toward and focused on women living with breast cancer under the age of 40. So the young survivors, us. My mission, my passion, my goals, my determination is to educate, educate, educate. I want to educate the medical communities. I want to educate the doctors that are in all of the hospitals, so that when someone like me walks into their office next time, they don't say to them, "You're too young to have breast cancer," because I wasn't. I definitely want to educate universities, and going in and speaking to all of the women that attend universities, high schools. There's so many people out there. There's so many people out there that don't even know that they have it inside them, that it's growing. And unless you get checked on a regular basis, and unless you do your own examinations, you know, hopefully you find it soon enough. Unfortunately, I didn't. I really, truly believe that I've been chosen. I'm the chosen one. This happened to me for a reason, so I have to do something with it. I can't just sit by and live through it. And there's some people who can, and they just want to try to get back to their lives. But I feel that I need to do something more. I want to be a voice that is heard, be a face that you can't forget. If it will help impact the right people that it needs to be effective to, then to make a difference, you know, to help us get closer to finding a cure, then I want to be utilized for this mission. Absolutely. I'm doing all of this because I don't want another young woman. I don't want this to happen to another young woman. It's not right. It's not right what I've been through.
Well, as my partner had talked about the cancer and the meanings, the types, and some treatment that many hospitals and many investigators, scientific, found for eliminate or reduce the attack of this problem or this disease.
Well, as my partner said, cancer is the accumulate of abnormal cells in a certain part of the body. And this can be confused with tumor, but tumor is like a mutation of the cells and it's related with the abnormal cells, but tumors and other diseases cause the name, the cancer. So we have many problems and the most important type of cancer is the breast cancer and the prostate cancer. In the breast cancer, because if the woman needs to be treated with surgery, it will be, she will lose his figure or the appearance for the whole of her life. And in the case of the men, they are going to lose their fertility for the rest of their life. Well, as we know, we have many causes, but not all have a proof about the cancer problem, because some say that GMOs are some of the most important points that cause cancer, and this is not an argument that have a certain proof about it. They just say it because certain investigations say something, but other investigations say the opposite to these investigations. But some activities that we do, some food that we eat, maybe can cause the cancer, like soda, fatty food, some products that have many artificial colorants and chemicals, and all those products can cause the cancer. Also, we have to note about the radiation of the sun. Radiation is a way to produce a transformation in the cells, and it going to are going to do a mutation on the cells. So radiation of the sun, we have to prevent, and we have to avoid these situations. And also, as we know, many investigations try to look for the cure for this problem, but we have still in investigating. But in certain place of the United States, they have approved in 257 women about breast cancer. And they use two types of drugs, and they found that just 10 women have a good response to this problem. So this is important because cancer is not like a unique problem for all humans. Cancer is going to be different for each people because we are genetically different in our aspects. For example, we are like the plants. Some plants are from the same species, but the variety maybe are resistant or susceptible to diseases that affect it. It is the same in humans. Not all the humans are the same. We are different in many things, and cancer affects just some and others don't. It's important to know to prevent this problem, maybe eating vegetables, maybe knowing about this problem. And we know that we have in the world many people that just have heard about the topic, but they don't know exactly what it means. That's important for us to explain to the other people about this topic. And also, many, in the case of the woman that survived to the breast cancer, they help to the other women to make a a test to make everything for them for save their life, because cancer can be treated when it was the beginning, but it was when cancer have advanced a lot, it's difficult to eliminate this problem. And it's interesting to hear all the speeches of the survival women, and also about other people that children that have survived. And many investigators try to look for this problem, to solve the problem, but it's difficult because cancer, we don't know still the causes, maybe some but not all. And the treatment are not like the cure for all. It's just like to destroy some parts of the cancer, but it will not destroy all the cancer. Also, my partner talked about the treatments, and they say about surgery, radiation, chemical therapy. All those treatments are very difficult because some people should have to pass for a moment of pain or have to lose some part of their body, something like that. And it's very, if we prevent this problem and not continue eating those kind of food, maybe GMOs have no proof, but it will be better if we don't hear it, because we don't know if they can cause it or don't. So that's all, and thank you for listening all our presentation about the topic of cancer. And we swear that you and all of the students and people around the world should have to know about this topic and should have to prevent and about all the things that they should have to know, they shouldn't have to know to do, and just that. Thank you for everything.